નમસ્કાર દર્શક મિત્રો, અતિથિમાં ફરી એકવાર આપનું સ્વાગત છે. અતિથિ એટલે એવો કાર્યક્રમ કે જે કાર્યક્રમમાં વિશિષ્ટ વ્યક્તિત્વ સાથે આપની મુલાકાત કરાવે છે અને વાતો કરે છે અંતરંગ. આજે આપણી સાથે એક એવું વ્યક્તિત્વ કે જે પોતે પોલિટિક્સમાં પણ છે, બિઝનેસમેન પણ છે, ભારતની બહાર હજારો કિલોમીટર દૂર રહેલા યુગાન્ડામાં પોતે પોતાના વક્તવ્ય છટાથી ત્યાંના લોકોને પ્રભાવિત કરે છે, યુગાન્ડાને કેવી રીતે ડેવલપ કરવું તેની ચિંતા પણ કરે છે અને સતત ભારત સાથે વ્યાપારિક સંબંધો રાખવાની પણ ચિંતા છે. મિસ્ટર સામ એંગોલા અમારી સાથે છે. સામજી, વેલકમ ટુ અવર શો.
થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ.
મિસ્ટર સામ, નાઉ માય ફર્સ્ટ ક્વેશ્ચન. દેર આર વેરી ઓલ્ડ રિલેશન બિટવીન આફ્રિકન કન્ટ્રીઝ એન્ડ ઇન્ડિયા. વોટ ઇઝ યોર પર્સનલ ઓપિનિયન?
માય પર્સનલ ઓપિનિયન ધેટ ઇટ ઇઝ કરેક્ટ, બીકોઝ વિથ ધ વર્ઝન ઓફ યુગાન્ડા એન્ડ ઇન્ડિયા, વેન વી ગોટ ધ ઇન્ડિપેન્ડન્સ ઇન 1962, વી વર કોલોનાઇઝ્ડ બાય ધ બ્રિટિશ. The Indians were also colonized by the British. So I think it brings us together. And then many Indians came to build Ugandan railways in Uganda. So they settled there, and there are many in Uganda and in Africa.
You are a vice president of, national vice president of NRM.
Correct.
The ruling party.
Correct.
Okay. See, politics is not a baby of everyone.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, how you enter in politics? I think that has been started in your schooling time. You were the most aggressive kind of student. You have raised some issues in school or college. What happened and when you entered in the politics, active politics?
Entered active politics because of the current government, the NRM. I like the leadership of the president of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. And that is when I entered the politics. But my background, as you said, my father was a leader,
okay,
a political leader. And my late mother also was a political leader. And me, as Sam Engola, I started being a class prefect from school. Up till when I finished, I was a head teacher. I mean, I was a head boy in the school.
Oh.
And I was in the debating club. So it made me got too much interested in politics. And because of my family and my father, my uncles and my aunties, they were all big senior politicians. So I grew in the house of politics.
I think the basic virtue of a good politician is a good orator.
That is the one.
And that's why you went to London.
Yes, I've been to London, I've been to America, I've been to India, I've been to Japan, I've been all over the world.
For special public speaking course in London.
Yes, I did that. And I appreciate it because I went for a real English speaking and talking and orator.
So, if you are a good orator, but I think every country has a different kind of politics within region, within country. Maybe how can you compare Ugandan politics with other part of the world?
Uganda politics with the other part of the world, first of all, there's democracy everywhere. But Uganda is a unique democratic system.
Okay.
First of all, in other past regimes, we used to have democracy, multipartism.
Hmm.
When the NRM came to power, they scrapped multipartism.
Okay.
Now, for many years, we were running the country on individual merit. When the opposition started making noise that they want us to go under multi-party system, then the NRM went for a referendum. And the referendum agreed to let us go multi-party. So we joined multi-partyism with a lot of cadreship and a lot of training that people now know what they're doing, now know the leadership we're going to have in Uganda. So we compare that to other countries. Our system was onlining behind. We were not voting. It was the indirect voting where you, if you're a candidate, I'm a candidate, people line behind us.
Okay.
Which was a very good system. Then you select your leadership, including the president. Now we go on ballot boxes, which we are also succeeding very well. There's no rigging, there's no cheating. It's very clean politics. That is why our politics is different from other people.
You fought election, you had been a member of parliament.
You
have enjoyed ministry also.
Yes, I was
okay.
A minister.
I think cargo trade and business is your favorite subject, and I think it is your personal interest to develop the business, particular for country. Okay, the countryman, the citizen of Uganda. I think you travel across the world, and measure your focus in India. What are the basic requirement of Uganda in term of business?
Thank you very much. First of all, I must count myself as one of the lucky Ugandans. Or my father made me be what I am. I went to a primary school in Indian school. It was called VH Public School.
Okay.
From P4 to P7. Then I went to senior 1 to senior 4 in an Indian school. It was called Town College in Lira, in northern part of Uganda.
That is your birthplace. Lira is your birthplace.
Yes. Yeah. My headmaster right now is in India here, Mr. Chandi.
Okay.
Unfortunately, God should forgive, his wife died in a car accident also in India here.
Mm.
That one son called Mr. Otim. Otim is a Ugandan name. Whereby if you are born outside, they call you Otim, means a forest. So this Indian boy is there in Uganda working. He's working with a company called Malicious Company, the general manager.
Mm.
And I always tell everybody that I'm a very good businessman because of the background of the Indian teaching me how to do business. And I always refer to my friend when I'm talking that my lady teacher was Mrs. Chandi, taught me commerce and told me if you want to do very good sales and marketing, you must use the most beautiful photo of a lady. There's a soap called Lux.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know whether it's still existing now.
No, it is existing. It is popular. Yeah.
Now, when you see Lux soap, you see the most beautiful lady on the
wrapper,
on the soap.
Hmm.
Outside cover. So that is marketing. You don't buy the soap, but you're buying the photo of the lady.
Okay.
Because she's really beautiful. And that was an Indian who taught me. So that's why I say I'm one of the lucky Ugandans who was taught by Indian. And that's why when I'm doing business worldwide, I always praise the Indians. I give the example of how good they are, how they know the business. And it is true. That's why you can see how Indian is moving very fast.
ઓકે દેર ઇઝ અ ટાઈમ ફોર અ બ્રેક. દર્શકો તો સમય થયો છે વિરામનો. મિસ્ટર સામ એંગોલા સાથેની વાત એકબીજા તબક્કાની વિરામ બાદ. વિરામત ફરી એકવાર સ્વાગત છે આપનું કાર્યક્રમ અતિથિમાં સામ એંગોલા સાથેની વાતો બીજા તબક્કાની. મિસ્ટર સામ, યુ સેડ યુ ટોટ બિઝનેસ ફ્રોમ ઇન્ડિયન લેડી મિસિસ ચંદ, એન્ડ આઈ થિંક શી વોઝ અ ટીચર ઇન સ્કૂલિંગ. યા નાઉ માય બેઝિક ક્વેશ્ચન બિફોર અ બ્રેક વોઝ વોટ આર ધ ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટીઝ ઇન યુગાન્ડા?
ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટી ઇઝ વેરી હાઈ ઇન યુગાન્ડા ઇન ટર્મ્સ ઓફ બિઝનેસ, ઇન ટર્મ્સ ઓફ પ્રાઇવેટાઇઝેશન. We have free trade. We have liberalized the economy. Anybody can come into Uganda with whatever dollars you have. You can get out with whatever dollars you want. There's no restriction. That is
okay,
number one.
Okay, okay.
That is an opportunity. We have investment authority, which is allowing all investors to come and invest. We give them incentive of 5 years, no tax. We give them whatever they want. They protect them. We have one stop center for immigration, for your work permit, for whatever you want. Once you get the lances, the same 2 days only, you get all what you need. That one is a very unique in Uganda.
I think the perception of the world, perception, I said perception of the world about Uganda or any African country, I think that is a security concern. People are talking about there is a lacking of security. The citizens are not safe. Is it so?
No. Uganda is the most secured country in the world. In East Africa, we are number one. All investors want to go to Uganda because at 3 o'clock, you can drive without any security. You can move without any hearing of any gun. Nobody is kidnapped. Nobody is harassed. Nobody is disturbed. So security is paramount and security is number one in East Africa.
Now, I think religious are more taking part in the emotions of the old citizens. And there are so many, you know, disputes and there are so many riots about when the religious part is on center. What is your personal opinion as a businessman, as a politician? Religious gurus, rather religious priests are taking disadvantage of this kind of emotions, or any politician are using the emotions to get vote, and they are trying to separate the citizens to get the vote only. About religion, what is your personal opinion?
My personal opinion is, first of all, very different from others. I am a Christian. I have done a lot of work for the church, and I'm still doing it, and I'll still continue. But these days, of late, there are too many religious functionalities in Uganda or in Africa, including America. Before, we used to have about four religions only. That is the Church of Uganda, which is Christian, the Catholics, the Muslims, and the Hindus. Now we have the Pentecostal, we have Church of God, we have so many names. Anybody who finds a way of making money come through religion way, which is very bad for the country and very bad for the people, which you have already noticed. In American embassy in Uganda, if you go with any letter of the church, they will not give you the visa, because they say that in America, it has become business. Every house, every two houses, there's a church with different names. Not like before, where we used to have three, four religions, which we used to know. But now, we have over 1,000. In Uganda, in Lira, in the northern, where I come from, I've already been complaining that there are too many new churches coming. Somebody can be rich, or somebody can think, today I want to open a church, he creates a name, and followers will be there because people are poor.
Yeah.
So they're helping them, they're giving them money, they start an NGO, get a free relief, so they're giving people, so they worship you, which is very bad.
I think terrorism is again a big issue. I think it is concerned with all the countries. How Uganda government is planning to fight against terrorism? Is there any specific plan, specific design, or they are just bang on 1, 2, 3 superpowers only? Uganda have any individual plan to fight against the terrorism, or USA will come, Russia will come, India will come and support? Uganda have any specific plan?
Yeah, Uganda has a lot of specific plan. First of all, for security in our country is the best. We have very many systems of security. We are condoning all those atrocities which they're doing. You heard the other day people from Somalia came and killed people in Uganda. They stopped them or they were arrested. That is a good sign that our security is very good. We do not support. That is why our country is in Somalia, because that is the center of terrorism.
Yep.
So our country is fighting left and right to see that they stop terrorism. And it is not there. And it will not be there.
Okay, fine. There is again time for a break. Darshak mitro, samay thayo che viram no. Antim tabakani vato sam Engola sathe ek viram baad. Virambha Fariko Swagashabnu Karagram Ati Thima, Mr. Sam Engola. Mr. Sam.
Yes.
Environment?
Super.
Pharma? No. My question is different. Environment, farming. I think these two sectors, I think African countries and more Asian countries are facing the major problems. And the third one is recyclable energy. I think solar is the most powerful tool in coming era. You are also connected with solar energy, solar plant, solar business. Tell me something about your vision, ki how solar business will boom in coming days.
Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to appreciate and thank the government of India, especially the Prime Minister of India today, Honorable Modi, for having helped Africa, in particular Uganda, on solar energy. We are here specifically for a trip as a delegation of Uganda with the Ministry of Energy for solar power and solar electrification. Yesterday we visited a super manufacturing solar panel and solar electricity in one of the states in Gujarat here by Mr. Kishore. It is called Power
Power what? Power.
There is a company of Mr. Kishore.
Power truck, yeah. Which were invited by a Ugandan, Indian Ugandan who lived there, Mr. Shashin Dijir, who invited us here, with Mr. Bawik, who we came with here. Now, we in Uganda, in Africa, people are still very poor. When we traveled yesterday 124 kilometers from this area, we find that there's no more village, although you think it is a village, but it's a farming area, there's electricity, there's water. When you come to Uganda and you go like to my area in Lira from the northern Uganda, people are still very poor, no electricity, people are still sleeping in grass touch house. I didn't see any grass touch house here. But now with solar, everybody is going to get electricity. Even the government of Uganda is fighting day and night to see that they build electricity power to help the people. We have today 112 districts in Uganda,
mm-hmm.
where the president with the government has been trying that every new district headquarters must have electricity. We have not yet reached. Every sub-county must have electricity. We have not yet reached. Now, if we cannot reach the district, we cannot reach the sub-county, how about the village?
True.
So with power electrification, it is going to reach a house of a villager or in a grass-touch house, it's going to get power. And you know, power is life, is like water is life. Those two, once you get, you're happy. So we are really grateful to the people of India for going to help us with solar electrification. And once we reach the target, Uganda will be like India. All these thanks we give it to Indian government, in particular to Mr. Pawarak, which has brought us here, and the people who are helping us to build this capacity in Uganda.
So maybe as per your planning, or rather the result of your visit in India, I think maybe it will fruitful for Uganda.
Very fruitful already.
Okay. I think you are inviting all the Indian who want to business in solar. I think you can appeal from our channel.
Yeah, we are trying to ask all investors to come. We are also going to come back again. We have the consulate, which is already working. We want them to open more so that this consulate can help the investors to take them to Uganda and take the solar people plus other manufacturing. Because first of all, once a manufacturer goes, he's going to employ over 200 people.
True.
That is giving work.
Yeah.
That is giving economy to boom. That is helping us. Yesterday when I went there, I found engineers in the panel factory, over 100 boys who have all got a degree in engineering. And they're working. In Uganda, we have over 4,000 graduates who are not getting jobs. But the more factory we build, the more people will be employed. The more solar power we have, the more people will get rich.
True.
So we are really appealing.
This will be the win-win situation, yes, for both. Yeah.
Okay. And we have the biggest community.
How you get support from African Union?
African Union is doing their level best, but you know, they work country to country. Which does not go to the village people. But solar is going to the village people, not to the town.
Yeah.
So we want to reach where the poor people can reach.
True.
And in Uganda, all the solar panels, all the solar electrification things are duty free. Government has a wave of tax in order to help the people who are poor to get electrification.
I think I have to ask you one question about North Korean, the people, what they are doing to disturb across the world. North Korean are doing something, hydrogen test, hydrogen bomb test, US, Russia, they are doing to protect all other countries. Now again. Particularly the peace of the world. What is your individual?
My opinion with international peace, we pray that people should have peace. North Korea, I don't want to talk much about them because you know the history of the world. You know the history of North Korea. They have never followed other world. They have been socialist until today. I think they're the only country in the whole world which are still socialist. Which means we can't talk about them because they're not for the people. So some people who are not the people, there's no need of discussing them.
True.
Because they can't go anywhere, they can't win anybody, whether they test what or what, America is there, British is there, France is there, Russia is there, China is there. The whole world is waiting for them. So they will not go anywhere.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sam. દર્શકો આતી વાત મિસ્ટર સામ એંગોલા સાથેની એક એવી વ્યક્તિ કે જે બિઝનેસમેન પણ છે પરંતુ પોલિટિક્સમાં છે પબ્લિક લાઈફમાં પણ છે એમણે જે પ્રમાણે વાત કરી તે પ્રમાણે આફ્રિકન કન્ટ્રીઝમાં પર્ટિક્યુલર યુગાન્ડામાં એક ઘણી બધી ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટીઝ પણ છે અહીંયા આવ્યા હતા એમના અલગ પર્પઝથી બિઝનેસ તો કદાચ સેન્ટરમાં છે પરંતુ સાથે સાથે બે કન્ટ્રીના કલ્ચર એક્સચેન્જનું પણ કદાચ ઘણું બધું કારણ કે ગુજરાતીઓનું ઘણું મોટું યોગદાન યુગાન્ડામાં કેન્યા યુગાન્ડા ટાન્ઝાનિયા ત્રણેય કન્ટ્રીઝની વાત કરીએ તો ઇન્ડિયન અને ગુજરાતીઓ ઘણા બધા છે વિવિશ કે મિસ્ટર સામ જે પ્લાન કર્યો છે જેમની ડિઝાઇન છે એમના દેશને ઉપર લઈ આવવા માટે તે તેમની પૂરી થાય ફરી મળીશું નેક્સ્ટ એપિસોડમાં એક નવા અતિથિ સાથે ત્યાં સુધી જ આપશો થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ થેન્ક્સ અગેન મિસ્ટર સામ